Good afternoon, everyone. So the previous speakers that has talked about very excellent topics, and sometimes I even wonder why I am here, because I don't really know if I could talk that great as them, but at least I think I will try my best. So right, today I would like to talk about the new wave of Myanmar cinematics. I think recently we are seeing, I think, the beginning of a new wave in our cinema. What I mean by that is we are seeing new movies with new perspective being made right now, especially from the youths. Our film industry has gone through lots of hiccups, and it has been damaged because of the political reforms, especially in the 1960s and then 1988. So it's damaged into a really great extent. So the causes of those reforms has been that many don't dedicate into the specialized roles in cinema, especially cinematography. Many don't take those kind of roles seriously. So cinematographer has to do the principal photography for a shooting, and he will also see what kind of angle works best in a scene. So, and then there's also art director. This is the role where very important to know what kind of set design works for the movie, and he or she has to decide for that. So these kind of roles are not underappreciated, and the director also seems to do those kind of things on their own because there is no formal education for those kind of roles. But right now, with the exposure to the global market and also at the same time having support from the international organizations, I think we're seeing a great deal of improvement. Especially right now, the writers are making the actors to do the serious character development. Deception, for example, use a method acting coach. So what he do is he has to drive the actors to do method acting. So method acting is the kind of acting where the actors don't act the characters. They don't have to act the characters. They have to become the characters, or in a way, to be the characters. And so that gives it kind of immersive experience where you can see the character, not the actor. And then other films like Dimensions and Nya also use the actors to do those kind of naturalistic acting. And I think facilities like Yangon Film School, for example, and then there's also festivals like Memory Film Festival, Wadang Film Festival. They are also helping these aspiring filmmakers to step into the industry and to help them, those who don't have the connection in the industry. So having connection means knowing someone in the film industry, like a famous actor or a famous writer, because those kind of connections of state plays an important role, because if you have those kind of connections, and if you have just a certain amount of talent, you can make it into the film industry. So they are still there, and we need to challenge those things as well. And another thing is there is star power. So what I mean by star power is when a film starring really famous actors, they're also great actors, like NATO, Myat or BDU. If a film has that, those kind of actors, the theaters will allow them to be into the cinema because they are guaranteed success, at least financially, because no one would not watch them. Everyone will watch those kind of films because at least they think it will be great. So there is also that, and it's also because of business. You know, if a film had these kind of actors, people will really watch them, and so this is a business model. A handful of people owns the power and the cinemas in the industry, and not that much diversity is in the film industry. But I think in the near future, we will see independent forces stepping out and challenging these ideas, mainly because that's what also happened in Hollywood. Before the World War II, Hollywood only has 5 major studios. So these studios make the movies, and only the movies made by them make financial success. Other movies would fail a lot. But after the World War II, the American government saw something that could happen if only a handful of people owns all the things in the industry. Because in Germany, they could make propaganda films because of that. They could do propaganda films because only one studio could have the power in all the in all parts of the industry. So the American government told them that they should let go of their theaters. And so the studios let go of those theaters, and the independent films start to flourish in America, and that's also how they got diversity within the system. There's also another thing. Whether this new wave that we'll be having, this new wave of Myanmar cinematics that we'll be having, whether it will become a success or not, also matters on our capacity to be able to adapt to the changes in terms of technology. Because cinema itself was born out of technology. From still photos, we were able to create motions using faster cameras so we could create videos. From them, cinema was born. And then there was also a really turning point in the film industry in the whole world. That was the transition from the film stocks to digitalized technology. This is also where our film industry, our Myanmar film industry, struggles, because we didn't want to change from those film stocks that we owned to make digitalized technology. We didn't have that much materials and workplace to do those. But right now, with the internet being very powerful in our lives, there's also streaming services like Netflix and iFlix and Hulu. Those kind of services are very convenient for the general audience, because whatever movie you want to watch, you can stream from them, from the server into your own house, into your own devices like laptops, phones, and tablets. So many people don't really go to cinema that much right now, because they could watch films with those services. So in order to get our movies or our media to the audience, we also need to use these kind of services to our own advantage. And the next thing is, so I talk about the technological standpoint. In terms of artistic standpoint, I think we need genuine filmmakers who express their works, who express their thoughts into their work, and not those who just try to impress people. So we need true artists who express and not impress people. So the film industry right now is not dead, that's for sure. It is not dead, but it is also not alive. To put it in a biological term, I would say that it is dormant. So what is dormancy? Dormancy is the period in the life cycle of an organism where it stops growing due to not having perfect environmental conditions. But it doesn't mean that it is dead. And I think our film industry today is like that. It is actually only dormant. And with our capacity to change into change and embrace the technological changes, and also embrace the new artistic changes, I think we can end that dormancy and also lead into the new wave of Myanmar cinematics. Thank you very much.